we are born to be kings. We're the princes of the universe. Here we belong. Fighting to survive in a war with the darkest power.
There can be only one podcast, and may it be the princes of the universe. Hi, folks, I'm Matt.
And I'm Bruce.
Oh, right.
Yeah, baby. Awesome.
Merry Christmas, you filthy animal. Hey, it's good to be back on YouTube, huh?
Finally, after all these years.
On the YouTube.
Not mainly because you were getting
When are you getting on our Facebook page? Speaking of lazy.
Merry Christmas.
Oh, man.
Who's on Facebook these days?
It's overrated. I'm not.
Let me update the MySpace page while I'm at it, too.
I'm telling you. Well, we have a whole lot of topics to get to today before we dig into other topics later on. But let's go ahead and talk about it right here, right now. Kathleen Kennedy's comments that on the Rolling Stone interview, they do not have any source. She's like, coming up with this content is so hard to get moved because we don't have 800 comic books.
Yeah, which is Marvel. Marvel had a source material that they can reach.
Oh, yeah. So they have no source material. They have no books to go after. They have, like Game of Thrones does. They have no, they don't have 800 comic books. That's true. They have probably 1,500 comic books to go after.
There's a difference between 800 and 1,500. They don't have 800. That's the main thing. If there was only 800, she'd be fine.
I'm telling you.
They made too many.
I'm telling you. But at the same time, you hear in past interviews her talking about how JJ and them got this idea from the books, from the comic books, from this, from that. And you keep hearing that. Well, okay, true or not? What are you doing? And then everyone's going, oh, she's such a liar. But the thing is, though, yeah, she lied, but she lied on purpose. I don't understand what the deal is about purposely ignoring the expanded universe, like pretending it's not there. Like Dave Filoni did this all the time. He said, oh, no, we didn't get anything from there. And I remember on the behind-the-scenes DVD, they're asking, where'd you get the idea of Darth Maul's mechanical bottom half? He goes, I don't remember where we got. And George Lucas' daughter sitting right there, and she went, yeah, you do. It's from the Vision book. Yeah, Vision. And she said that. He goes, oh, what was it? He didn't want to admit. That's where he got the idea. And I was like, what a turd.
There's a rumor that we might get a Darth Maul TV series.
Am I supposed to care about this?
Hey, look, everybody is right now very excited about the Midichlorians.
Are you
People
excited?
People love watching Boba Fett rescuing a baby Yoda, and introducing, where the Midichlorians then spread out through the rest of the Jedi.
Obviously, you want
People love this show.
Obviously, you want to talk about Disney Plus already.
People like the Midichlorians.
Okay, so we're done talking about Kathleen Kennedy. Screw it. Okay, anyway, Disney Plus. How's The Mandalorian?
It's really good. I'm enjoying it so far. I'm 3 episodes in. Okay.
I get a lot of questions from people who don't know the expanded universe that well, but they know that I like it. They said, so, you're watching Mandalorian, right? Why would I watch Mandalorian? Well, isn't that expanded universe stuff? I said, no, that's new canon. That's not old canon. I said, wait, that's not the old canon? I said, no. Oh, well, I thought it was. Why do you think it was? Because it's really good. I'm like the new canon?
I'll say there are memes going around. It's like, finally, Star Wars fans are not complaining about something.
I mean, there's a few Star Wars fans who, of course, aren't happy about a few things here and there.
But the thing is, the one thing I noticed, and one way it looks a little cheapish, but at the same time, it finally clicked on me. It's like, no, they're making it look like the original movies.
Oh, okay. Doing the mask and
special
stuff.
Effects. Okay. Some of the special effects are better than the original movies, like with some of the creatures. But some of it, it's just like they would, they made it to fit with the original world.
So in your opinion, is The Mandalorian the best thing to come out from Star Wars so far?
With the new canon, probably.
Better than the movies.
I haven't, I'll say that once I'm finished watching all the episodes. But
well, I mean, three episodes in. So far, it's beating Last Jedi and Force Awakens. Not yet.
Those weren't my favorite of the new canon.
I know. Okay, that's fine. I know. But
yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
So far, it's beaten most. Well, Rogue One. What about that one?
Rogue, I mean, we'll have to see. Like I said, I've got to finish.
That's fine. But so far, it's looking promising.
Yes, very promising.
Okay. And then are you excited about Obi-Wan?
If it's like this, then yeah.
I'm shocked they're even acknowledging the prequels, bringing you and McGregor back. I'm
they,
glad.
They finally put out like one prequel era book.
So is... you said Darth Maul, is that for real? Are they doing Darth Maul?
I think that's just the hype they're putting out because the Mandalorian is doing so well. They decided, oh, and Luke might do Darth Maul too. We'll see. at this point, it's doing, that's like, finally people like a Star Wars thing. People actually
spending money. Is Ray Park's coming back?
He came back for Solo, so why not?
Oh, okay. He was in Solo?
Yeah.
Okay.
For a second.
Okay. As Darth Maul?
Yeah.
Oh. Okay.
You didn't know that?
No, I didn't know that. It's in the movie.
Remember at the end of the Clone Wars, he was heading up Black Sun?
Okay.
It kind of had a reference to that.
Oh, okay.
He was...
Shown?
As a hologram.
Oh.
He's still alive? As the leader of Black Sun.
Oh.
It's before he died as Obi-Wan's hand.
Oh, that's right, because Solo's a prequel.
Yeah.
So Solo takes place prior to Episode 1. Dang, Luke isn't even born. Is there that big of an age gap between...
No,
I thought there was a 10-year age gap between Han and
Solo
Luke.
Took place between 3 and 4. So after Luke was born, but before Episode 4.
Oh, okay. Okay, so...
And before...
Was Luke like 10? Maybe.
Exactly
did they show Luke?
They don't show Luke? They don't like putting an exact time.
Did they de-age Jake Lloyd and put him in as young Luke?
I would have watched.
Jake Lloyd would have watched that. Because he was just watching his career passing by. Okay. Is he out of jail yet? I have no idea. I tried looking up information on him after his arrest. Nothing.
Cares.
He's off the radar. Sad. It is sad that nobody cares about him. It is sad. I agree.
It wasn't his fault. He was a young actor. I agree.
I completely agree. And he got butchered. And the thing was, he wasn't the right person for the role, and George Lucas is not a good director.
And nobody wanted to see a little kid there. That's not what we were planning to watch from the prequel.
No. So a lot of pressure. He's being told he's being great, and then he gets mocked by fans. And this is right at the turn of the century when the internet is finally becoming something.
Yeah.
It's not big yet, but he's big enough to look on
it. But people learned, hey, we can complain on this thing.
Who was the first internet troll? I wonder. Back in the late 90s, what would you have been trolling about back then? The ending to Roseanne? What do you think the first thing that really got hate by a bunch of fans online? I wonder. It could be something big like Star Wars. Star Wars was big back then. Shooting the forums, Kevin Janderson was getting killed.
Really, some of the earliest stuff I remember...
That was the first time I remember hate being thrown at people, was Kevin Janderson.
Kevin Janderson.
Well, because Timothy Zahn was mocking him, so all Timothy Zahn's Zahn fans were echoing that statement about him.
So Timothy Zahn started the internet hate, that's what I'm saying?
Holy cow, Timothy Zahn was the first internet troll. We think we just nailed it.
Yeah, with Zahn.
Kevin, why don't you shave your beard and look like a dork? TZ. TZ man. I am Thrawn, 93, 91 was his screen name. You just gave yourself away there, Tim. But, okay, so speaking of Disney Plus, have you seen the new... I haven't seen the new scene for Episode 4. I've heard about it, I read about it, but I never saw it yet.
New scene for Episode 4?
They redid the Greedo, Han Solo...
Oh, yeah, I did watch the clip, yeah.
Macaulay, or whatever.
It just smoothed it out a little bit, made the shots a little closer to time.
Were they both shoot at the same time now?
It wasn't nothing special.
Why just go to the original version?
Yeah.
Why can't we do that?
I don't know. Lucas must have put that in the contract when he sold. I think everybody would like to do that, except for Lucas. And the only reason they wouldn't is because they can't, for some reason.
I like how
they did smooth it out a little bit. That original shot released in theaters was so terribly clunky.
Oh,
they cleaned
it
up. They cleaned it up a lot to where it's a little smoother and doesn't look as bad.
Shoot. I don't know. Greedo shouldn't have ever shot.
No.
Kathleen Kennedy was asked, was George Lucas coming back to do another movie? She went doubtful. Yeah, because he hates the movies. But he's under contract. He's according to the Bob Iger book, he's contractually obligated to not speak against the new movie. That is in his contract. That's from Bob Iger.
Oh, man. No wonder he's not talking.
That's, I'm telling you. That's amazing to me. Okay, so Disney Plus, what all else are you watching? Are you happy is on there? Because, like, nothing I wanted. Like, I was like, great, we finally get to see all the Ewoks cartoons. Oh, what about the Droids cartoons? I mean, oh, what about the 2003 rotate. Clone Wars?
They
oh,
well.
Ewok movies? Oh,
speaking
Condor
of 2003,
Man? Oh.
Jeffrey
Tarkovsky.
Whatever. Back in October, he released this little short series called Primal on Adult Swim.
Mm-hmm.
5, 15, 20-minute episodes. Fantastic.
Fantastic stuff.
He kind of, you know, stuff. No dialogue, just grunts and growls, caveman dinosaur fighting, just crazy stuff, just crazy situations. At this point, just watching my kids love it too. We've probably watched all the episodes.
You talk about a true visionary. He's got it, man. Without dialogue, and you can still make something interesting. I remember we marveled at this when season one came out of Clone Wars, and how there was no... I mean, do you remember I talk about this all the time on my channel, but Anakin versus Ventress.
Yeah.
And how they fought, and there was no dialogue, but yet there's that scene where they're both looking at each other in the rain, and the rain's hitting the lightsaber.
Oh, I love that.
And the
something
tension.
Never thought about what would happen in the lightsaber line. Like, oh, that's it. That's what happened.
But it was just so good.
Yeah.
And I remember I was like, I cannot believe how he doesn't have any dialogue, and
thanks.
It's great.
Because, you know, Brody has become a huge fan. He's been watching a lot of his stuff. You know, of course, they liked Powerpuff Girls and Dexter, but, you know, they didn't really attach his name. Plus, those weren't his strongest things. Those were just kind of an introduction.
You mean Dexter's Laboratory? I'm thinking Dexter
yes,
from Showtime.
Yes, Dexter's Laboratory.
Of course he likes Powerpuff Girls and a serial killer who kills serial killers. I'm not a good father, by the way. Go ahead.
So, you know, he started watching, because of Primal, he started watching... Samurai Jack, and he wants to watch.
I hear Samurai Jack's really good.
We started watching half the first season. It's pretty good.
Remember, that's where his name was when he. That's all I knew about him. He did Samurai Jack, but I never saw Samurai Jack back in the day. I knew it got, you know, high accolades from people, but I never watched it myself. And they're like, "Oh no, it's gonna be great." It's like, I don't know, man.
It doesn't look that good. It's one of those weird things where, like, part of it is like super serious, and part of it's SpongeBob. It's got this conflicting serious narrative and zany.
And then Hotels Transylvania 1, 2, and 3.
Yes.
What?
My kids love those.
Oh, I didn't even realize it was him until the third one came out. I was like, wait a minute.
There's a difference between those are work for hire. Adam Sandler.
I understand.
Movie, he just directed it versus the stuff that he writes, directs, that's his.
I know. You got to make that money. That's like Sam Raimi. You know, he said, I made that Wizard of Oz,
I mean, like,
whatever.
Primal was not something he did to make money. That was something he did because I think it was just like, okay, here's some limitations I'm going to put on myself and see what I can do with storytelling.
That's the
Primal. The Primal is the dinosaur caveman.
Oh, no, I haven't seen that.
It's just brand new, came out in October. Mm-hmm. Fantastic. You can get it on the Adult Swim app. That's where we watched it.
Where's all the X-Men and the Deadpools on Disney Plus? Do you think they're doing a separate thing for R-rated movies? This is all kid friendly, which is another thing at this point.
Because everything is, you know, from Marvel and Avatar are like the highest rated, you know, most risque, violent things that they have on Disney Plus. So I'm assuming at some point they'll probably have an add on. They do have an add on for Hulu. Maybe they'll expand all that into
Hulu. It's called Hulu Dark. Disney After Dark. That'd be something. Disney After Dark.
But yeah, I want to find out. You know, we're missing lots of Disney princesses. Where's my Ridley? Princess Ridley.
Who's Princess Ridley?
Queen alien.
Who's Princess Ridley?
Ripley.
Oh, you're talking about the Fox stuff. Okay. Well, I mean,
they're all Disney princesses
now. For some
now.
Reason, they put The Simpsons on there, but they didn't put anything else on there. So that is weird that they've kind of excluded a lot of the Fox stuff. They have a lot of stuff they could put on there.
Well, they're going to rotate. I mean, it's going to be like Netflix.
No, I mean,
they rotate stuff every few months. They definitely, you know, it definitely looks like they loaded up heavy with a lot of nostalgia. My kids are digging in. Like, when I left the house, they were watching Old Yeller.
Old Yeller?
Yeah.
What, do they know what happens in the end?
Well, they read the book in school.
It doesn't matter. It's different when you see it on, you're like,
know,
oh,
I
wait, I did. I skimmed through the book.
There's a reason why I left and came over here. That scene got me every time as a kid. Mm, I mean, I do remember bawling at that scene many times.
You know what? I've never seen that movie. Yeah, I know what happens, and I never saw it. We never saw it because I don't care about dogs.
I'm watching it. It's a fun movie. I mean, it really is.
I'll have
movie.
To give it a
it's,
watch.
It's classic old style.
No, it's on Disney Plus. Hey, do they have the Apple Dumpling game?
Yes, they do. Brody was asking about it because he's a big fan of Andy Griffith.
Oh,
And they want to watch Treasure Planet, Apple Dumpling. They just find stuff they've been out to
bring. That's interesting. Maybe I should dig back through this because I guess it didn't do
a lot of the old stuff that you haven't seen in a long time.
Okay, I knew they had bed knobs and broomsticks. I was like, that's interesting. So I need to go back through there. Do they have the original Flubber?
I don't know. Maybe.
I don't know. That would be or Doctor. It wasn't called Flubber. It's called
The Nutty Professor.
Nutty Professor. Yeah. Oh, no. Okay, so there's a few other things I can look at. I've been looking... Oh, and you said they were watching the X-Men.
The 90s X-Men. They were really enjoying that.
Yeah, I remember liking that. It was a good show. I just don't have a desire to watch it.
I mean, I would agree with you. I mean, it's a little 90s drama.
Yeah.
And it's not my style.
I don't think it would be...
I picked on it back in the day of being the drama they put in. It was a little... cartoony,
yes. Literally, like yes. Kind of silly.
But, you know,
see, I don't think it like Batman the animated series. It holds up today.
Very strong.
But yet, I think if I saw X-Men 90s, I'd be like, one as good as I remember.
Speaking of Gentry Tarkanovsky, that's where he's got his feet. Was on that Batman animated series. That's where I think that might be. It's not his first job. It's one of his first. He was just a low level at the time. But
well,
I was like, hey, he started there. He trained under the best. That's why he could.
Yeah. Oh, sidebar. Speaking of Disney, streaming service that won't be around, DC. I'm done with Titans after the season finale.
The thing is, they should have just done a WB streaming service. It was too limited with just DC. DC does not have enough stuff.
No, it's just, and they're terrible.
I mean, really, if you've had it for a year, you've had time to watch everything worth watching. And why keep it?
Exactly.
Disney will be able to rotate stuff and keep you there for years.
What all are you watching on Disney Plus? Is this for you or is this for your kids?
I mean, I plan on watching the Star Wars and the Marvel shows as they come out, but it's mainly for the kids.
My wife may be watching.
No, and you know, Brody has picked up a love of Tim Burton, so we can watch the Alice in Wonderland and Dumbo.
They got all that kind of stuff. That's true.
I never bought those because I wasn't a big fan of those, so I was like, oh, no. And now they're streaming, so.
Okay, I'm looking through here. This is nice. They have it done through decade on the one I'm looking through. I don't know. The one thing I don't like about Disney Plus is it's... what was the thing? Oh, they don't do picture within a picture on your mobile phone like YouTube and my other streaming service does.
No, you can't shrink it down.
You can't shrink it down and do something else while I was playing that. Netflix doesn't, but there's other ones that do. They should. I don't know why they wouldn't. But, all right, well, I'm trying out Rescue Rangers, almost through with it. Not as good as DuckTales. DuckTales is pretty solid today. My brother told me that, and he was right. DuckTales is pretty solid. Rescue Rangers is not as solid.
But something to do while I'm eating. Yeah, I haven't watched DuckTales since.
Tailspin's next. I'll probably have this done by the end of the year. And then Darkwing Duck, which I'm really excited for because I remember loving it. I'm sure it's not going to be as good, but still loving it. Emperor's New School, because I love Emperor's New Groove so much. I don't think the new school will be that good, but... I do want to see it since I love the movie so much. It's the prequel.
Go for it.
It's probably not going to be any good, but I'm happy to see it on there because I've always wanted to watch it.
Speaking of which, I don't know if your kids have seen Emperor's New Groove.
Oh, Emperor's New Groove is the best Disney animated movie out there. It's hilarious. I love it. It's seriously my favorite animated Disney movie. And then...
Which we are going back and watching old ones. We watched Lady and the Tramp the other day.
Oh, really? Yeah, I mean...
I will say that is the fun thing. You know, how long I keep Disney Plus, I don't know, but at the moment we're finding some old gems that, you know, things I haven't seen... Kind of thought about like Apple Dumpling Thing. That's going to be watched this week just because, you know, Barney Fife's in it. And, you know, we're going to watch it. I remember liking it. I don't remember anything about it other than I liked it.
Yeah. My wife is upset. She wanted the, there is a lot of goofy shorts that was on the Disney Channel that you watch all the time. I may watch those again for good laughs and good memories. My wife was really upset, though, because... One thing that was not on there that she really wanted was the Dumbo Circus. And what was the other one that was like, Winnie Pooh Corner or whatever? You know, those live-action people in costumes we used to see when we got our 2 weeks free of Disney back on TV. So she was upset. She really wanted to see those, but they weren't on there.
Yeah, I'm kind of disappointed they didn't have Condor Man on it.
I am super disappointed. I'm serious. Condor Man, I was hoping they'd have some of that stuff that's kind of, you know, put Condor Man on.
It's not that hard.
It's going to
be there eventually. They're going to rotate the stuff through. The thing is, one thing I'm curious. The Mandalorian. tons and tons of holiday special references. Will they release it?
What do you mean, tons of holiday? Tell me.
First off, his weapon is Boba Fett's weapon from that cartoon.
Oh, okay.
And then there's
John Favreau did say he's taking a ton of stuff from.
And then they reference Light Day.
Oh, that's hilarious. Wow.
One of his bounties. He's captured a bounty.
I would be so happy if the Star Wars Christmas special was new canon as well. It's got to be new canon.
Everybody's got to be settled with that crap.
It's got to be new canon. They have to have it too. Now, I remember, okay, this makes sense because I looked at a title of an article that said he'd be open to making a new Star Wars holiday special. Like doing one for Disney Plus. I doubt Disney Plus lets them do it.
They ought to at least put out just the Boba Fett cartoon. Because everybody agrees that was the highlight of the whole thing. And it was a good cartoon.
Now, let me ask you this. Speaking of all this Disney Plus stuff. Have you watched... we talked about this. The Toy Story shorts.
Oh, yeah.
I got to see them. And some I've seen...
The thing is, they're not new. Just so you know.
No, they're not new. I know they're not new. But I got to see them. One I hadn't seen ever before. I talked about it with you this morning. Party Sorceress, which is about Bad Toys, which is hilarious.
Yeah.
Hilarious. It's a great movie.
It's a rave.
Yeah, I thought it was hilarious. I laughed the entire time just about. Small Fry, dealing with like McDonald's toys or fast food toys, I've seen before, but I still love that one. I think that was a great idea. I'm guessing these were all ideas that got pitched for Toy Story 4, but they said, nope. It's too funny. Make it a short. because Toy Story 4, Small Fry had Condor Man in it, which is what I really loved about it, too. But there was a lot of funny stuff in Small Fry, too. The one that was the weakest was Barbie and Ken's
Hawaiian Vacation.
Hawaiian Vacation. That was a that was kind of a dud.
It's fine.
A little bit. I mean, it was okay. There's a ha-ha moment here and there.
That was in theaters before.
What was that one in? I remember seeing that.
I want to say it was before Tangled or something. You know,
okay, because I remember, I think I've seen this before. Seen Familiar.
All of them were, I think, in theaters.
Oh, really? I know I've seen Small Fry somewhere. But Party Source Rex, I'd never seen, so I must have missed the movie that it came out with that one. But you said it was on one of my DVDs, probably. So some of these short films were. But it was interesting to see that. Now, Forky Asked a Question is one that I don't really care about, but we were talking about this right as you came in.
Yeah.
Why don't you tell your little story about Forky Asked a Question and your kids? Forky Asked a Question.
Yes, Forky Asked a Question. They only really like one of them. But Forky, what is a friend? Remember, Forky makes friends with a cup with a smiley face, printed on it. These little 2-minute short films, my two youngest boys. They think it's the funniest thing they've ever seen in their life. And so, their mom doesn't quite know what these are, but, she comes, gets them up, puts them down, like, Mom, we want to watch the show, we want to watch, and she's like, okay, put this on while I get dressed. She can't even get her pants on before the thing's over and they're asking to watch it again. So she's annoyed. She's greatly annoyed by these little shorts because it's not enough. The kids want more, they want to watch it on repeat,
I'm glad they're short. Because, in fact, it needs to be a minute shorter. I'm not really enjoying this. But I didn't like Toy Story 4 that much. I thought it was the weakest of the four movies.
Yeah, it's the weakest of the four. I mean, it's good.
It's a fine movie.
You're comparing it to the three of the best movies made.
My biggest complaint was it was about Woody and Buzz, which is the right-hand man through all three movies. He's almost written out as a minor. He becomes a minor character. I was like, what is this all about? And then you explained it to me.
And the rumor mill is that Tim Allen's basically being blacklisted in Hollywood these days. They didn't really want him back, but he's Buzz, so he has to come back. So you've diminished the part, because of his from his show that was on ABC. What was that? Last Man Standing.
Okay.
And ABC. He came out strong for Trump, and it's like their highest rated show on ABC. Or one of their highest rated shows, and he comes out for Trump, and then all of a sudden they cancel it. And, people are like, okay, maybe we understand why you're writing Buzz Lightyear out of the series. If they go make any further movies, right. Buzz Lightyear will not be in them. Basically, Woody and Bo Peep running around doing whatever.
That won't be interested anymore.
Yeah, which is not interesting. It was really kind of...
It was a real letdown, too.
Because we talked about this on this show, on the podcast.
Toy Story 4?
I think we did. Talk about it. That seems such a departure from Woody's character.
It did seem like a big departure. I don't think we talked about this.
He was so tied into the kid, and now he's like, I'm going to help the toys.
Well, I'm leaving. What about the girl?
Well, the thing is, he went out on a mission. He changed his mission. Understandable, they're going to give him a new mission. But he was so tied into the kid is the only mission that mattered. And now it's, well, I'm going to help toys. And it's only because of the girl, sort of. He's fresh, because he got left behind, really. He's like, oh, because I'm not the favorite toy, it's not worth it.
But you've never been the favorite toy. You've been sharing others. You got over that. You got in the first movie, you accepted that you weren't always going to be the favorite.
He struggled with that in the first movie, and so it felt like a departure for the character.
I just thought it didn't jive well. It felt like a direct-to-DVD movie, is what it felt like. I was like, man, this
is... It was better than most Disney direct-to-DVD movies.
I'll be honest, there's a few of those shorts I enjoyed better, and I enjoyed Toys That Time Forgot a whole heck of a lot better than 4. I'd say Toys That Time Forgot, I need to rewatch it again, but I loved it.
That one gets watched a lot.
That's a great one. It's a great one.
Mainly because of dinosaurs.
So I'm looking this over, and they have Pete's Dragon. They have it's called the Absent Minded Professor, not the Nutty Professor. Nutty Professor was Eddie Murphy, which I doubt is on here. But the Absent Minded Professor is on here. Pete's Dragon, Apple Dumpling Gang, and Apple Dumpling Gang Rides Again. So that's really nice.
I'm going to go refine a lot of those movies that I liked as a kid and watch them with kids. Because the kids are really enjoying these old Disney movies.
Now, they have Spider-Man and His Amazing Friends. I used to watch that all the time, but I think I'm going to pass. Is the Hulk cartoon with that?
I don't know which Hulk. They do have some Hulk cartoons.
Okay. Mickey's Christmas Carol. I used to watch that around Christmas.
They also have the Muppet Christmas Carol.
Oh, gosh. That is definite for the holiday season.
That's actually, we're pulling it out Thanksgiving week.
That one, The Grinch. And what was the third movie I said was going to be watched for sure in this house? Muppet Christmas. There's a very Muppet Christmas on one of my streaming services. Yeah. Like, well, I'll watch that. I've never seen it. I don't think it's going to be good, but I'll watch it. But honestly, there was something else, too. I thought that it's time to watch this Christmas movie again. I can't remember what it was, though.
No. And it's kind of perfect because we have been watching the Jim Carrey's Christmas Carol, which is phenomenal. It's really, it is a really good telling of the story.
I saw that a while back.
We've been watching that annually. I think this year I'm going to just put on the Muppet one instead. Give it a year break. Give them some time for it to build up some more nostalgia for them. But, the Muppet one, I haven't seen in a long time, but I do remember it being really good.
Fly the Navigator, pretty good. 3 Men and a Baby's on here, too.
About 3 Men and a Little Lady?
I don't know. That should be on there. Did it come out in the 80s or 90s? It looks like they have the whole store of Disney animated films on here, though. I'm looking through this, and I think I see it.
All the major ones. I can't think of any major ones that's not on there.
You got Honey, I Shrunk the Kids. Oh, not. I thought that was a 90s classic, but it has an 80s. But, all right. So some neat stuff, to be sure. Oh, yeah. 3 Men and a Little Lady. There it is.
Hey, hey.
Look at that. It has it all. It even has White Fang. Doesn't have White Fang's hit. Dude.
I just put White Fang on the list for the kids.
Did you really?
Because, well, Annabelle, they were going through the books that they read in school.
Ooh, The Rocketeer. You need to watch The Rocketeer.
I've been wanting to for a long time.
Honey, I Blew Up the Kid. You don't need to watch
it. I haven't watched those since, I've seen...
Rookie of the Year, Funky Butt Loving, Three Musketeers. That was a good one. I saw that one. Little Pimple. I will run you through. Yeah, there's a lot of stuff on here. Okay. So, neat there. Thumbelina. Wasn't that Fox? Get what's on there. Okay, so Return of Jafar, which actually has a really awesome... Return of Jafar was actually a really good sequel.
Aladdin sequels
are pretty solid.
They're like the only ones that have, watchability.
Oh, they still have Tim Allen's Santa Claus on here. So watch it, folks, before they remove it.
I might throw that one on for this Christmas.
I saw that a few years back. They were okay. I watched them back to back to back because I didn't see them when they came out. While You Were Sleeping? Why? Why is that on there? Anyway, okay.
I think they're looking for anything that's kid-friendly that they can throw on there from the catalog. So if it's a PG romantic comedy, I guess they'll put it on there.
Maybe so. All right, so next topic. I think we're moving on from this. Unless you got anything else to say about Disney. What do you want on Disney Plus that isn't on there now? What do you want them to do? Let me just end with that.
I don't have, I mean, I would like for them to have everything Star Wars related that was ever put to film, but, you know, we'll have to wait and see.
Okay, but they do have the old Incredible Hulk series, the 90s cartoon.
Yeah, but they won't plan on watching that. Maybe we'll finish watching that.
Okay, and the Quack Pack, which I won't be watching at all. Okay, so, moving on here. Going to move on to our next topic, Tremor 7, which everyone is talking about right now.
Everybody, meaning us.
We're the only,
but we're excited. Man, we are excited.
We're cornering the market with Tremor 7 news right here.
We're like stalking, Bert Gummer. Michael Gross.
Yeah, Michael Gross, man. It's a fantastic series, and I love it to death. I probably it's going to come out when? Because it's just filming now.
They turn these over pretty quick. If I had to guess, I'd say it'd be up October.
Jeez. I don't want to wait that long.
It might not be that long.
I'm excited. Too. Jamie Kennedy's not a part of it. I won't miss him. He was fun in the fifth one. He was pointless
in the second.
In the follow-up.
Which was kind of good.
But it's not on bad terms, it sounds like.
I'm intrigued by Michael Gross put up a picture of himself. And, you know, and he's got long white hair, long white beard.
Yeah, it looks interesting.
With no context, he just put up a picture of my new look for Tremors. And so it's like, what are they doing? Where are they going? I know they're filming on an island. Is this like a lost island? Him trapped on an island with a graboid? It would be a fun idea if that's the way they're going. Who knows?
Yeah, we don't know much about it, besides it's getting filmed right now, and he looks like a,
crazy Santa Claus.
Crazy Santa Claus, man. But we know we both love Bert Gummer, and I know I'm just going to love it, because I think Michael Gross does a great job. He has fun. I am sad they stopped with the numbering. I thought it should be called Tremor 6, the last one. In fact, I may have liked it even more. But Tremor 6 was a letdown for me. Calling it Tremor 6, I can't remember the subtitle now. Remember what this was called?
It was the one that was supposed to take place in the
Arctic. Good, we're calling it Tremor 6 then.
You know, filmed in
the desert. Oh, and that looked like a fan film, too. That was so bad. It looked bad. Now, I understand they're really cheap, but 5 was actually pretty good. We both enjoyed 5 a lot. 5 is pretty good. It doesn't beat the first 3. It seems like every time they have less and less money to work with. But to be honest, you can do a pretty decent job. Unfortunately, you can't show the graboids as much, but I wish Universal, is it Universal that owns
them? I think so.
I wish they'd throw them a little bit of money. Just a little bit. Because they obviously know, if your movie series is going 7 strong into direct-to-DVD sequels.
They take all that money they wasted on a monster, Universal Monster film universe, where they tried starting up 2 or 3 times, hired all these big-name actors, and didn't make anything with them.
Absolutely. They're wasting money on other things.
Let's bump up Tremors. Let's put some life back into it, baby.
I agree. I think Tremors
is
well.
I hope that eventually they release that pilot that Kevin Bacon did. I know it's a big departure from what we've had, but I'd like to see it.
I didn't like it because they were going to stray away from the movies. And you think that's why it bombed? Because I think Tremors, if you're a Tremors fan, you're already a hardcore fan because no one else cares about Tremors. But I think the hardcore Tremors fans are so invested in these movies right now that they didn't want any. They love Kevin Bacon, but they want him to come back
to the series.
Yeah, to the series, and he wasn't. And I think that made a difference.
Possibly.
So I don't know. I don't know. I think that's why I wouldn't want to see it. Is what I'm saying. Unless it was connected to the overall, storyline, which it could be easily. A lot of things could have happened. I want Fred Ward to come back.
Yeah.
Spring for some extra money. He's not Why doing not? Anything
what
right
is he doing
now. He's not doing nothing. Bring him back. I would definitely be excited to see someone else. I'm glad they're bringing Michael Gross back. He's the series right now. Also.
Spring. He was the series then, too.
Let's try to get Reba McEntire back. Let's get them back together. Yeah, that should be. But that'll be the last movie, though.
Then you
have to have Reba in all of them. And you can't have Reba in all of them.
No.
But I do want him to get back with... Is it Heather? Heather, I think. But I want him to get back with Heather at the end of this song.
He never got over.
They don't really admit it that much. I want to see people. I also want to see people from the third one. You know, they're basically forgettable characters, but bring back some more continuity.
Yeah, the TV show.
No, the TV show is great. TV show is great. But, I don't know.
I wish that would have gone longer, but I think it was... Was that Fox? No, I think...
Well, no, it was on Sci-Fi Channel. They didn't treat it right. They didn't give it enough love, and it needed more love for it to go even further. But
it was a good premise.
It was. And I thought they did a very good job keeping everything in continuity with the movies. They did a great job of introducing all the little hooks that you see from the movies. And at the same time, the story was really good, and the characters were enticing. In fact, the characters from 3 were supposed to be in the movie, in the TV series, but contractual obligations led some of them, they couldn't get them all. So they couldn't get some of the people, so they had to replace. And instead of just saying, well, this guy will play Cactus Jack. No.
They wrote him out and put a new guy in
to take over Cactus Jack's role. And he even says, I bought Cactus Jack. I'm probably not going to change the name, because everyone knows Cactus Jack. But I'm Jim, or whatever his name was. Yeah, he was the Cactus Jack replacement. But the thing is that they didn't even get lazy enough to say, well, it's TV. Let's just get a new, different actor play the same actor.
Yeah.
No, you can't play the same character. So I like their attention to continuity. And that's the reason. That's the other reason I like Tremors. But there's no Tremors merchandise. There's no Tremors comic books. There's no Tremors t-shirts.
There's Tremors comic book in the movie and TV universe.
I know, Dan. We don't have
some in the real. Dark Horse.
We're
there in the universe making them. Why not in the real world?
I know. I want this. I want more of this. I understand why we don't have it. So, yeah. You need to get on it. Disney Plus needs to make a Tremors. Oh, wait. They're not on Universal yet.
Yeah. Give them another week.
Okay. One final thing. If you didn't already know, Brian Bork, the president of Twin Suns, announced that the...
El Presidente,
as no one calls him. Yes. I may start now.
Word up, Brian.
Yeah, he said that the billboard's going up in April. That's because there's maintenance due to a billboard. They offer another billboard.
No wall will keep him away.
I'm telling you what. They offer a bigger billboard, like a ways away from where we wanted it. And he's like, nah, I think we'll just wait for them to both be available again. And that leads to April. So it'll be out in April, but still, I'm super excited because now that Star Wars has announced there will be no movies right now. They're putting a kibosh on movies. They're going to give it some breathing time.
Meaning
you said that trending on Instagram and Twitter or social media, Rise of Skywalker's numbers are not, right?
But the thing is, The Mandalorian might be stoking back up the flames again, but... Before Disney,
you think that's
Plus
why they released The Mandalorian before episode?
No, I think this was a long-term plan with Disney Plus and The Mandalorian.
Okay,
I think it's just coincidence. But before that, Star Wars was trending down, and it was definitely on track to be the lowest opening Star Wars movie.
But now you think it's trending a little bit higher now.
We'll have to see.
But that's Mandalorian. That's not the same thing, right?
But it's getting Star Wars back in people's minds.
Oh, that's true, I guess. So that's why they did it?
That's not why they did it, because it was planned before all the other stuff started happening. This was long-term plans, was The Mandalorian premiering on Disney Plus. Disney Plus had a hard start date, which is why they had so many problems the first week.
But either way, they're stopping movies. They're going straight TV. It looks like they're pumping stuff into Disney Plus, like with... the rumored Maul and Obi-Wan. So now, I'm so happy we did the billboard now. It just, fortune has it to where now they got nothing going on. It's going lower tier now. Not big movies. It's now just TV shows. And it's not TV shows on big channels. It's on TV shows on a streaming service, which, by the way, is a smaller audience. So now, 10 million, yeah. But, to be honest, after we use it for free, you're not worth it. Anyway. But the thing is,
you're
though...
You're not watching them anyway. It's not you they're going after.
That's true. They're not going after me. They're not looking after me at all. That's why they have all those runoff, the Immortals. What were the Eternals? What's the TV shows you told me? Runaways, Eternals, and what else did they have?
Inhumans.
Inhumans, and what was the other one?
Cloak and Dagger.
Yeah, not watching any of those.
Yeah.
Neither am I watching Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. again. It was one of those things,
pardon me, I've always had this hard commitment. All Marvel media I will consume. And I keep finding excuses not to watch these. And now it's like, oh, look, Disney Plus. There is zero reason. It's so easy. It's right there in your face. All you have to do is press play. Crap. Get back to watching.
Are you going to watch him?
I'm going to say yes.
Oh, my
gosh. We'll
see
if it actually happens.
The
plan is to, but the drive is not quite there.
Personally, don't know if I'm going to watch any of those. I have zero desire to watch any of that stuff. We had talked about this earlier, and I just, none of that stuff just really interests me.
I watched the first season of Runaways. It's
tough. Like, I even gave Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. a second chance. It was awful. I couldn't make it through but six episodes of Agent Carter. It was so bad.
I liked Agent Carter and Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. I didn't have the problems you had.
Ugh.
But I'm not a hater like you.
Oh, whatever. I mean, I even tried to go back to Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., but it was just awful, awful, awful. But I think now's the perfect time to bring a message to Lucasfilm that, hey, how about some new Legends? Because you're not doing nothing else. You ain't working on movies. They told us, hey, guys, we need to focus on this trilogy first. Okay, the trilogy's done, and here we come. And this is the part where we start knocking. I love this because now we're knocking on the door in the biggest way possible. Not one billboard, but two billboards. And it's years after our first billboard. They thought they got rid of us. No, they didn't.
And just looking at what they found doing with Marvel, there will be an Elseworld-style Marvel. They're doing What If on Disney+.
Yes, they're doing What If. So
if
now
they can do that, then they can do something for Legend.
Yeah. I mean, seriously, you're correct on that, because the future's wide open for us right now. So the odds could be in our favor, especially if we're throwing billboards out there. The biggest resounding message ever, because by that time, Rise of Skywalker will be done. It'll be a forethought in everyone's imagination. It'll be out of theaters by then. And so then this billboard comes up. It's the perfect time. So I'm so happy. I'm so happy we decided to do this. And the fact that they're not working on any more movies right now, just on TV shows, and just on TV shows to a direct audience and not to anyone, is just perfect. It's perfect. Because you don't have any more. Like Bruce doesn't have an excuse not to watch Inhumans. They don't have an excuse to say, hey, we're working on these new movies right now. No, you're not. You got nothing going on. So why don't you give us some more Legend stories? I love it. I love it. I love that we're doing stuff while you have other people who are just like, they want to make fun of the billboard, but at the same time, what's their plan? Their plan is to buy more Legends. Yeah, what do you think we've been doing for the past 7 years, doofus? That's been the plan, but guess what? It hadn't been working, so you got to do something more. You got to let your voice be heard. Yeah, I'm going to complain on the internet. Good job. Good job. I'm sure Lucasfilm will be watching you. Oh, wait, they won't. But you know one thing they will be watching is their billboards. Yeah, on their way to work, on their way back, too. They're going to see those every day for 30 days. It's going to be awesome. It's going to be awesome. It's going to be on the nerd news, too. I can't wait. I can't wait. It's going to be great. Hey, you know what? And I would love for them to say, okay, you know what, Del Rey, if you want to. Cause I know Del Rey wants to. They just can't. They're not allowed to. I know Marvel was really happy with the results from 108 because it was a big-selling comic book. It was called 108, not number one.
Mm-hmm.
And it only got beat out by a number one comic book, a new Star Wars number one comic book. So it was really a big one. How can issue 108, a comic book that is continuing a series from back in the 80s, be in your top 50 sales?
Nostalgia.
Yeah. So why not keep doing it, too? Why not let Marvel continue the old Marvel run, too? Because who knows? And I trust Matthew Rosenberg to write all these because I think he's very connected to the Expanded Universe. He knows this is the market I'm going for, so I need to make sure everything connects. He made connections in 108 that I wasn't expecting. I was expecting him to be true to the Marvel comic book series, and that's it. No, he acknowledged the rest of the Expanded Universe and fixed something, too. You know, the name that they give the New Republic is not the New Republic in the comic book.
Yeah.
But it's the New Republic in the book, so what happened? Well, 108 explains that. Why aren't you calling yourself this? Yeah, we decided to call ourselves the New Republic. Hey! You didn't have to do that, but you did, because you knew. You knew people like me were watching. So I was reading it. So I really like that. I'm excited. Man, if this gets this new expanded universe, which there's a very good chance now, especially when there's no movies coming out.
Why not?
Why not? All right. So that's it. That's all of our list. Anything else you wanted to add?
I love you. I miss you.
All right, folks. We'll see you next time on Princes of the Universe. We were born to be princes of the universe. Okay, you can get off my lap now.
You're elected.